Some new developments in this shocking incident in Platteville last year when a train slammed into a police cruiser with a detained woman trapped in the back seat of a car. The victim was seriously hurt but miraculously survived and now is filing a lawsuit. FOX 31'S Talya Cunningham joining us in the studio with that lawsuit and more on her recovery. Talya.
Yeah, Erica, this lawsuit was actually just filed today in Weld County for negligence among other things. So take a look here. You can see these crumpled images right here, brand new into our newsroom. Just shows you how mangled and destroyed that police cruiser was after a freight train came barreling at a high rate of speed. So the victim, let's show you this right here, 20 years old, Yareni Rios Gonzalez, pictured here. Now, she suffered multiple broken bones. Her attorney telling me today she's finally able to walk again, but still has a long road ahead, now seeking justice.
She wants people to be held responsible, for the police to be held responsible.
Paul Wilkinson, attorney and founder of Paul Wilkinson Law Firm, speaking on behalf of his client, Yareni Rios Gonzalez. The 20-year-old was handcuffed, trapped in the back of a police cruiser as a train slams into it. She suffered 9 broken ribs, a broken arm, and fractured sternum. Now, she's filing a lawsuit against the Fort Lupton and Platteville Police Departments and the 3 officers involved.
I mean, it's really about the current state of policing.
She's suing for negligence in a civil rights claim that points to wrongful actions of police officers.
It's a pretty open and shut case. I don't think anybody's looked at the video and said, well, you know, maybe they're not at fault. I mean, I think it's really established that they are at fault.
The lawsuit states Rios Gonzalez heard the train coming and was banging to get out, but the doors were locked. This diagram in the suit shows the car was pushed about a half mile on impact.
We've seen with George Floyd and Elijah and Aurora, you know, there needs to be a better standard of policing. And
police detained Rios Gonzalez after an alleged road rage incident where a driver claimed she flashed a gun. She was charged with felony menacing, and despite the train crash, the charge has not been dropped.
We do not agree with the charges. We will be fighting the charges.
And the question on many minds, why did trained officers park on train tracks?
I think it was a really dumb decision. I don't know why.
Yes.
And I suppose we're about to find out.
So Wilkinson tells me now that that lawsuit has been filed, the legal process and likely negotiations will play out to hopefully reach a settlement. But if not, they are fully prepared to take this to trial if need be. Of course, we'll keep you posted. In studio tonight, Talya Cunningham, FOX 31.
All right.